questions?
Thank you.
reads, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. Jesus was a true man because he perfectly lived the life of God. He was the walking God. There was no separation between God and Jesus. And because no one can destroy God, no one can destroy Jesus. God manifested the power of resurrection so that the world could see that Jesus was never destroyed. This is why Jesus' love is the beacon of hope.
Sibong Toribiong was baptized in the Catholic Church. She lived her faith in showing examples of love, of care, and of guidance to her family. She lived for the sake of others. She was a beacon of hope for her family. Let us likewise live for the sake of others. It's our calling on the Great Commission from our Lord Jesus Christ. We will now offer a song together.
Lord, AIDS battle stage 4 colon cancer. Maria Sibong Toribiong was born on April 10, 1947 in her native home of Palau to her parents, Kumar, Bismarck, and Madame Dick Toribiong. Sibong was very active in her home community and was revered as being a strong spirit student and leader of Girl Scout Troop 1947. She graduated from Zinti High School in 1968. She was determined and had dedicated much of her time in finding ways to improve her skills to provide for her family. Those who knew her as a daughter, sister, cousin, mother, and aunt would know that even though she was a little headstrong, she would go above and beyond to help anyone in need. She would go out of her way to show kindness, whether it was through cooking or baking something delicious. She was popular, and needless to say, did not mind dancing in the spotlight. She would be remembered chanting, Sibong is the Lord. And Maria Sibong had much pride as an islander, being from the most beautiful island of Palau. She worked hard to seek a better life for her three beautiful daughters, Cecilia, Luella, and Prudence, and her first husband, Dr. Anthony Bloom. Although the two parted ways, they had much respect for one another. Early in her career, Maria sought to secure a future and her daughter's needs by earning an education as a seamstress and clerical proficiency. Not only did she find time to sew matching outfits for the girls, she would prepare a tightness clerk, she would prepare a better employment utilizing her skills. Maria secured employment working as a tightness clerk at the District Department of Education in the War from 1969 to 1975. And Trust Territory Headquarters of Education Department of Saipan from 1975 to 1976. With the offer of promotion required her relocation to Saipan, Maria had to leave her three daughters under family care. This took a tremendous toll on her. As she recalled, the hardest part was saying goodbye to my girls and then asking, why did I have to go? She then decided to return her kids in Palau to work for the Department of Public Affairs in Kuala. 1976 to 1978. It was in this time she met U.S. Air Force officer Barbara Gold Arms, who would become her husband and wonderful life. Robert took great care and time courting Maria, and they soon became engaged. The two married on February 14, 1978, at the High Court Chamber in the North Lab.
Maria Sibong Toribiong was a great deceased by her mother, who married me to She is survived by her daughters, Cecil, Harm, Global, Harm, Greg, and Michael, Prudence, Harm, Melanie, Deb, her sister, Susara, and Mission, Giella, Tom, Trubia, her brothers, Mike, Ian, Mike, Ananya, and Christy, Trubia, and Dan, Edith, Molly, Lilia. Her grandchildren, Charlene, Supporter, Matthew, Craig, Josiah, Thompson, Jacqueline, Porter, Adara, Thompson, Josiah, Thompson, Tillman, Gibb, Major, Gibb, and three great-grandchildren, Violet, Claire, Brandy, Socha, Sibong, Graves, Thompson, Teresa, Jaya, Fabio. A host of nieces, nephews, grandnieces, and grandnephews. Her legacy will live on through her grandniece, Dominique Maria, baby Sibong, Lila Gomez, daughter of Shelly Ann, Judella, and Jonathan, Lila Gomez.
She wore a beaming smile. That smile was constantly interrupted by her endless words of welcome. Ali, may, there too! She was dearly overjoyed. She hugged me tightly. She peppered me with what seemed to be a million questions. I barely had time to answer one. And then she said, "You have to eat." Not sure what food I preferred, she prepared the American food and Palau food. Tired of mashed potato and bland flounder from the school cafeteria, I went straight for the Palau food. It was delicious. Every meal she made thereafter was delicious. Sibong always had Palau music playing. She cooked, she danced, and she spent hours chatting me up. I'm sure my sisters also wanted to spend as much time with me, but it's as if Sibong was telling them, "You already had your time when you guys went to visit your siblings in Palau. It's my turn." This theme would repeat itself 4 years later in 1997. When Molly graduated from Xavier and followed me to Stanford. Like me and my heart, Molly and Melinda, who's also with us today, would also become beneficiaries of Sibong's generous Palau hospitality and gracious fatherly love. Molly recently shared her story of when she first went to Sibong's home and was fed bilum and fish soup after months of howie food. Because of delicious food, Wole fell in love with Sibong. Wole is still in love with food, obviously. Recalls being shocked when Sibong's husband Bob Arms would tease Sibong, still obviously flirting with her, and Sibong would get back at him by giving a bird. Wale was shocked with that. I wasn't, because I was already used to it. They were a lovely, loving couple, even if Sibong appeared to be wearing the pants most of the time, waving all the time. Sibong again would keep playing clown music. She would camp up off of his recliner to make him cha-cha and argue like with her. I can still see Bob doing his shoulder wiggles. He dearly loved her dearly. Much more than he loved his old Milwaukee gear, cigarettes, and football. As Bob likes to say in the mornings, beer before coffee. I can probably just sum it up by saying Sibong truly opened up her arms, her home, her heart to us. I would say, there's a Palau phrase, Ilimangrapuri. Maybe to figure it out. She always gifted our spirits. I have tried to return her generosity and kindness a few times she visited Palau over the years. But I still feel that I did not. Sibong and Bob were moved to Lakeland, Florida. And Bob passed away and went to his home state of Arizona. But Sibong remained active, worked, and tended to her home garden. I believe she has tingkang. I don't know, you showed me the tingkang lemons and papaya and tropical plants since she planted those down in her home. Then, in January of 2021, out, let me know of some bad news. In just a short time, Sibong was bedridden. It was cancer. She was taking all sorts of medications. And it was frustrating for me because, you know, we can't do much from here. So I just quickly ordered a bouquet of flowers. And when they were delivered on January 10, 2021, obviously I looked up my records. Lulu and Drew were there when the flowers were delivered. They were able to find time to call me when Sibong was alert and give me medications. We must video chat and messenger. Lulu brought the phone to Sibong. Sibong looked at me and appeared to be wondering who is this fool smiling from ear to ear. I couldn't help myself, it was so nice to see her. I said, she was still trying to figure it out. I said, and then all of a sudden she just kept, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. It's a relief to know that my face had a better effect than the flowers. We kept smiling, we spoke, we cried. It was so bittersweet. Sweet because we were connecting once more. Bitter because we knew it was probably last night. Yeah. 9 days later,
que será, será. what will be. Now I have children of my own. They ask their mother, what will I be? Will I be handsome? Will I be rich? I tell them tenderly. Hey, said I, said I.
Come to Jesus Kitchen, please. I miss you.
What did you get Grandma for Christmas? What did you just say?
A green card.
A residential, permanent residential card.
Okay.
Or I'm gonna be deported. Hey.
Thank you, Grandpa.
Thank you, hon.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Birthday, dear Mello, the big
5-0. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
You say goodbye, I say birthday. You say birthday, I say
day
happy
birthday. Birthday.
Birthday. Birthday, birthday, birthday.
No, you can't blow them, Mom.
He goes like, yeah.
I'm like, hello.
Yo, that's crazy. I don't even remember. Like, I remember it like subconsciously.
The sound, right?
Yeah, that's crazy. Do you know that? You recognize that?
Nah, I can't kind of recognize that.
That's awesome. That's crazy.
The human mind is a
crazy
thing.
Which one is that?
Gotta give him a 9.
Oh, gotta give him that. Gotta give my nine, my nine, my nine, gotta give my nine.
Hey, two steps.
I am seven, nine, go.
Numbaga tu, numbaga tu.
And story, yes, go. What a key, and seven, nigga, seven, nigga, ten, my only day.
And my only
day. Get up, get up, get
up. You know the dance, bro?
I don't know the dance.
No, sir. No. Oh, you are kidding me. You are giving me hell.
No.
Oh my God! I like you. Oh my God! Look at how many there are.
No!
Hey,
no!
No!
What did you get Grandma for Christmas? What did you just say?
A green card.
A residential, permanent residential card.
Okay.
Or I'm going to be deported.
Thank you, Grandpa.
Thank you, hon. Yonande.
Grandma Coomer and everybody in Palau.
Merry Christmas and we'll be sarak. Ang kumalasan din nila, Christmas sir kami, Manya kaliw. Until next year. Bye.
Bye.
Sibong.
I tried to prepare, you know, a speech and just, you know what, I'm just going to try to speak from the heart and get through it with outright, first and foremost, I'd like to thank you guys for supporting us and evidently you're here because you either know us or you have a connection with our mother, who's open to say something. So we have also sisters and sibs here with us. And we got to let her know that hopefully you're not here. I'm trying to do it. Holy Spirit. We really can't express our gratitude for our families on both sides to help us get through this, where we tried to learn some of the best through our mom, who really, you know, iterated the fact that we need to know that we are Palauans. We need to know we come from, you know, the beautiful island of Palau, know our place, and know our place. The most important thing that she wanted us to do, this woman is very straightforward and serious and very organized. And so even through our last weeks, you know, she went through stuff with all of us. But the most important thing that she wanted us to do was to bring her back home, to rescue her mom, because she is Palau. Mom really tried hard to teach us Palauans and traditions and Palau roots, you know, often through riddles that we didn't know what we meant. You know, we weren't sure how to take it. It's only until we came here, we started to get the definition and to make the adults teaching or really dark though now. We need so much more. Not that she's, one of the comments that she would often say was, "My identity comes from slavery, this part." She was so perfect that she wanted to be here. She didn't want to be everybody else. She did things her way, you know. So she could say something like, "No, not me. I am different. I do things my way." I am Palauan, and I am Sibong. I am Sibong number one. And she always wanted us to know that. You know, people are like, oh my gosh, she takes things in vain. You know, it's all about her all the time, but when we come here, everybody, our family, you know, we really respect my mom. Our mom. I say my mom, I'm selfish, I always say my mom. Very proud to see all of you guys here and be part of the celebration of the love. Like we said, she doesn't want us to be sad. You know, she wants us to be happy and dance and continue to dance and sing, you know, in her spirit. All right, guys. So thank you so much. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Come on, let's love.
For you, that's why I'm here.
always moving because even in sickness, even in the very time that she was about to leave this place, she was thinking about her children and making sure that they were okay when she left. Even though they were grown adults and their own children, she still had that. There is no one as important as that between a mother, between a father, and their children. And so even though Sibong is gone, and this is really good, thank you. I want to say, Sibong, thank you. Not only because you did that to your daughter, it is something that I got it from your daughter, and I'm sharing it with the crowd here. We are all related. That is a lesson to be learned for all of us parents. Now, there is not much we can say to say thank you. Because I to me, thank you is the very presence that you're here. That's thank you enough. You know, words really cannot convey your presence over here. And so I will end with that. I say thank you. This is something that cannot be replaced. You know, the presence cannot, you know, only have one presence and one presence. And so if you want to say thank you, you show up. That is it. Words cannot come in. And so again, Om Sula, Abhyanadala, Sibong. Thank you. I know that when we die, we go to the site where they're going to put ashes in the ground. And so I ask that everybody took that and we will be blessed.
kaon del mama Dios sin maral masaul. Era tar kama para si bungo na utak tirigal mo tapo ko dalap. Il mar mama bibir ra kama. Lagi de orot yang terro para madame mal di merenga sule mi bibir la tar kama para si ko. Lagi pa arsil time lagi bo mo tapo to permi. Magulong itong bumbrut arandi rarbek lap. Ilakal mo kita arandi. Yang namor bitar kau. Hindi wedyan na lang nung uutyal mo ng mo. At tayo mamo ang motur ka matumiura Yesus patara klabasay ibon sa edel mo bitar asiko. Makmaliol terkong postirgal bedir ringin marangargel kumbrut arandir e mga lao tertir isir kutal nga ru ibon sa ilam ang dasur kao rapek talpung rakyo ortir. At imeral diol tanga sarkada diol ng asomos magkikimbring asulim lorit kaya kakfiel ang algemo dingalo sa kalabo Yesus Kristus.
Amen.
Irgal baby rengaka maldi adarang baro tem mo sube sa igel ko ragi di straight tingi. Ikmal mo ban trira o bakmamara ang musigil si alum at pisong at dibus matulik kaya maltar ulgalam irgal yagok mestiam at ito magok mo ng arbo tena. Makti mo akpitar ang kal hotel gegeres tiril ba odirir ananias e maral dimreng asuli war adala adam tirgal ngal bua gimral ngal tangat il hotel gibem kel divertian e sa o gordeu ma mare de rabol ba gimral dimreng asuli e blamo bebi rakma al timi mal somiu e tire gam lambur ramel kayo kumende kasin tiri bo da ta ke do to patvin kal tar kamam. Umurail mo niya ang arang, ila ka mo ubesil lot ka mami, mo na ka mami magigong na kayo siya. Kumalusaw na.
Natura ka siya.
We can do one.
Ano niya sa lang kayo mo na siya?
Yes.
Buta, matara lulu. Sabiri ko nga rin na niya.
Alika
ka dito. Yeah, I think
Bravo.
Jam lak mar lagi kita teri.
Oh, mungkin mana?
Apa yang kami mungkin?
Rancangan mes.
Hola,
AJ. 15 more seconds on my thighs. Thank you.
With her big picture in the background, right there. All right. Mommy moment. Mommy.
Family here in Palau.
Yeah. It's big. We're realizing that.
All right.
Yeah.
I've been hearing that Sibong had a last daughter. But always Sibong, your mom is coming here, but...
I never came with her.
This is your first time?
Since I was born. Yeah.
She's my niece, for example, one is, how do you call it? My sister, the oldest one, she was age.
Okay.
And we used to play together. Because our house was closed.
Yeah.
Since we are related, very close.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh. I really miss you, Mom.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm going to go to the hospital.